What can we say about all this? If God is on our side, can anyone be against us? God did not keep back his own son, but he gave him for us. If God did this, won't he freely give us everything else? If God says his chosen ones are acceptable to him, can anyone bring charges against them? Or can anyone condemn them? No, indeed. Christ died and was raised to life, and now he is at God's right side, speaking to him for us. Those words come from Romans chapter 8, verses 31 to 34. When elementary school children choose sides for a game of softball, the teacher can almost always tell which team is going to win just by seeing who is on the teams. If there's a particularly gifted athlete among them, the side that chooses him or her is the one who will win the game. In the game of life, we all choose those who will be with us. Now, not to oversimplify it, but if you choose God to be with you, you will win. If you do not choose God, you will lose, and that loss will be for eternity. Now, here is an amazing thing. God has already chosen you. God wants you to be on his team. Not because he can't win without you, but because you can't win without him. If I was on the team that won the World Cup, and I only sat on the bench for the entire time, I would still be recognized as a member of the team that won the cup. If you have chosen God and decided to let Jesus Christ be the Lord of your life, your eternal salvation is assured. Not because of anything you have done or will ever do, but because of Jesus and what he did on the cross. I may play the game with all my heart, mind, soul, and strength, but Jesus scores the winning goal. Lord Jesus, I choose you because you have chosen me to be with you forever. Who can succeed against me when you, Jesus, are with me in this life and forever? To you, Jesus, be the glory forever and ever. Amen.